implications of it. As oftentimes we believe that religion, that deen, see, we have a very limiting definition of religion and deen. For example, if a person is looking to get married, right? As maybe many of you in this room are. If a person is looking to, you know, complete half their deen, is looking for a good spouse, and, you know, their teachers, their parents, the scholars, it's how them look for deen, right? So we all know this, we got this, okay, we're supposed to look for deen, right? But then we have this challenge of, well, how do I know a person's deen, right? Well, oftentimes what happens is the definition of a religious person is very superficial. Very superficial. So for a brother, it's the ones who have the biggest beard, the shortest pants, if that's what they do, and they can maybe recite the most hadith. And that's awesome. That's all very awesome. However, our definition of deen is just very surface. It's a person maybe who has the most things memorized, which is great. But sometimes, and on the other end, we have with sisters, it might be very much a surface thing, right? Although unfortunately, and this is just a side thing, a lot of times there, even among, I found this trend that even among very religious brothers, there is an absolute, positively complete definition on looks. The Prophet ﷺ, for example, gave us a definition of a religious person. He says in one hadith, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. Now, all of a sudden, the Prophet ﷺ has given us a litmus test for character. That's what he's doing in this hadith. He's giving us a litmus test for character. And what is that litmus test? He's saying, the best of you are the best to their families. So right now, we already have a litmus test. He actually didn't say, the best of you are the ones with the longest beards. Yeah, okay, this is a beautiful thing to follow the sunnah. However, when he's really talking about the litmus test of a human being, of a human's character, he says, look at how they are with their family. Why do you think that would be a litmus test? Well, there are many reasons. Number one is that what happens behind closed doors is behind closed doors. It's not on social media. How you are with your children, how you are with your parents, how you are with your siblings, that's a hard one, isn't it? Right? Because the reality is, we sometimes have it flipped. We aren't the best with our families. We're the worst with our families. We save the best for outside the home. Isn't that the truth? We save our politeness and our kindness and our generosities and our pleases and our thank yous for the people at the grocery store, for the maybe the teller, maybe the waiter, maybe the people in the masjid. But once we get home, all the pleases and thank yous are done. They're expired. You know what I'm saying? And now all of a sudden, sometimes we even go to the extent that our family is our punching bag, both figuratively and literally. This is an extreme, right? But even if it's not physically our punching bag, although sometimes it actually is, we use our families as our emotional punching bags. So we're frustrated with our boss, we're frustrated with our teacher, we're frustrated with someone, you know, someone, whatever's happening to us outside the home, we come home and take it out on the people inside the home. And this is the exact opposite of what the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us. He's teaching us we're supposed to be the best with the ones in the home. Meaning on our best behavior inside the home. Not the other way around. Because the way we've got it often is that we're on our best behavior outside the home. We come in the home. Now it's our time to relax. But relaxation unfortunately means I don't have to be on my best behavior anymore. You get it? I can treat them however I want. I can talk in whatever tone. I can snap. I can this. All of a sudden, we're not so concerned about the feelings of the people inside the home as we were just concerned with our colleagues and our boss and even just the teller at the grocery store. That's a big problem. And it shows a problem in character. It shows actually a problem in character. Because the Prophet ﷺ gave us the litmus test. And the litmus test is خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. That actually if you want to know who is the best among you, in what actually matters, not only in your dress, not only in what you can recite, not only in, you know, the external, superficial, like the surface things, but in really your character. The litmus test is how are you with your family? How are you with the people closest to you? The people who we tend to take for granted. The people who aren't paying our, our income, our check, our monthly check. The people who aren't giving us that status. You see, because at the masjid, how we behave in the masjid, we get something from it, right? You know, that's a status thing sometimes. It's an image thing. What are people going to say? What are people going to think? I want people to think of me a certain way. You know, this feeling of wanting that. But in the home, you know, there's no trophy at the end. There's no position. No one's, you know, putting it up on social media. It's not being Facebook lived. But if you really want to know a person's character, truly test a person's character, you look at how they are with those in their family. You look at how they are with those closest to them. Those who don't have power over them, but they have power over them. Who are they? Their kids, their siblings, their parents. You understand? The things that are in private. And why does the Prophet ﷺ tell us this? Because here's the amazing thing. If a person can be on their best behavior, this is called ihsan, by the way. Ihsan, don't ever think ihsan means perfection. Sometimes it's mistranslated. Ihsan doesn't mean perfection, because there's no such thing as perfection except with Allah. Human beings are not perfect. Human beings are not perfect. This doesn't mean we are expected to be perfect. However, ihsan is to strive for excellence in everything you do. To strive for excellence in your behavior, to strive for excellence in your manners, to strive for excellence in how you treat everyone, whether they can benefit you or they can't. All right? And so if a person is able to have ihsan with those in private, then that's the real test of how they're going to be with those in public. Make sense? If you want to really know a person, you know, because at the end of the day, as they say, you don't really know a person until you live with them, or travel with them, or deal with them with finances. You know, the Prophet ﷺ told us that you don't really know a person unless you deal with in certain ways with them, certain circumstances. And one of those circumstances is that you travel with them, that you're with them in a living situation, in an extended period of time. Why? Because that's when somebody is uncomfortable. Travel is uncomfortable. Travel is not, I mean, even now with all of our, you know, our transportation, our comfort that we have airplanes now, we're not on camels. However, it's still stressful. You know what I mean? When you're missing your flight, or you're close to missing your flight, or someone is being, you know, discriminating against you or whatever, you're put under stress. And when a person is put under stress, it tests their mettle. It tests what they really are. So if you really want to know a person, these are some of the ways. But I'll tell you this. If you want to know a person, say you're trying to get to know someone for marriage, and you want to know that person, look at how they are with their family. Look at how they treat their mother. Look at how they treat their father. Look at how they treat their siblings. Because even if a person is, you know, sometimes you might have someone who's really, really great with their parents, alhamdulillah. But then again, you always also have mama's boys sometimes. However, if you look at how they are with their siblings, you look at how they are with people who can do nothing for them, then you start to understand the real metal, the real character of a person.